Grandma made miniature rolls that would melt in your mouth. They were so light, the aroma would flow throughout the house. She made the best peach cobbler in the whole South, but she couldn't remember her soap. Her apple dumplings didn't last very long, and my favorite sherry chicken would fall off the bone. And if you waited too late, your helping was gone, but she couldn't remember the soap. Granny played piano and could sew like a pro, and there weren't many places we didn't go. From her garden, you could see she could use a rake and hoe, but she couldn't remember the soap. She would organize marches for civil rights. She taught her children to stand and fight. She would walk the floor and pray all night, but she couldn't remember the soap. She didn't have much schooling, but lots of common sense. Bought herself a house when she got tired of paying rent. Could count her money down to the very cent, but she couldn't remember the soap. An opinionated woman who would have her say. Some people called her bossy, if you looked at it that way. But she did something good for someone every day, but she couldn't remember the soap. In the cool of the evening, after a long day's work, Granny ran bath water after ironing shirts. As she sank into the tub to remove the dirt, she thought, I forgot the soap. It was sweetheart soap, big, oval, and pink, and the thought of the smell made my memory blink. As I sat on the back porch with my eyes closed to think, why did Grandma always forget the soap? As a girl, Granny had no indoor plumbing. At her house, there was no water running. To get the soap, all it took was turning to the dish by the side of the pan. She called from the bathroom, "Get me my soap, please." As I got up, my brothers would tease, but I didn't mind. I did it with ease, 'cause my granny needed her soap.